You've got the rules down, good enough. Your mechs are built and painted, hex map out, ready to step into Battletech. So what is the next step? How does one actually play a game of Battletech? That's what we're going to explore in terms of options, because there's a lot of ways to approach a mission, to approach a game, not only from a wargaming perspective, but also from the narrative perspective. And at this point, kind of the key indicator for Battletech is a value, is a computation called battle value. We see them on the printed sheets for both the beginner box and the game of armored combat, but they're a little bit nebulous on just what exactly this is, what exactly this represents. Now, there's a formula. I'll leave that for looking in the Total Warfare book, mech creation, vehicle creation, and kind of some of the online sites that allow you to crunch the numbers. But essentially, taking the tonnage of a mech, the weapons, the armor, other configurations, and coming up with a numeric value that represents the power of that mech, and the same with vehicles and infantry and air support on the table. So the idea is, if we're playing a game to keep things about fair and to give us diversity of units that we can select, we agree ahead of time, let's play 4,000 battle value. And on a side note, in a moment, we will explore some of the ideas of what is a normal game of Battletech, or at least in filling out a normal game of Battletech, some of the considerations to keep in mind and to add into this battle value. So if you have 4,000 battle value, 6,000 battle value, you and your opponent and the other players can agree ahead of time. The idea is I can spend that battle value on mechs. I could go all assault. I could go a balanced lance. I could go all lights and any combination in there. It allows you to explore your collection or explore options and more or less keep it on a level playing field. Now, this is where things get a little bit more complicated, and they can be resolved by ahead of time by some communication, as long as it's not a blind mission, meaning special parameters, like I'm going to attack this base, or my opponent has hidden stuff on the table and I have to discover it on there. That's the narrative idea, because you don't want to spoil it. But playing Battletech from the perspective of mechs, playing it from the perspective, secondary perspective of vehicles and infantry, and then we add in air support and other kind of secondary things like artillery, naval units. Pushing in your battle value, there should be some qualifiers ahead of time of what can be included or not. A great example is if we just say 5,000 battle value and I have a big collection, you can go in all mechs. I can bring some pretty heavy air support. I can bring some aerospace fighters that have the tonnage and weapons of a mech, and you don't really have an answer for it. So on paper, well, it equals the battle value, but the stratification of the game itself really kind of will force you, will deal you to struggle a little bit with what's being put out there. So I like to agree ahead of time, if it's possible, to say, okay, I'm usually battle value mechs, vehicles, and tanks, because they're kind of on the same level. But as soon as we move into air support and artillery, is it a yes or is it a no? I don't need to know what you're going to take. You're not going to know what I'm going to take. But at least if I know ahead of time that you might spend your battle value, and likewise I might spend some of mine on air support, I can make those tactical decisions. Bring some good defense, bring no defense, bring a little bit of defense, and kind of push it out there. So for the most part, battle value is how the game is spent, the currency, and pushing forward. Before battle value, and there's still some players that utilize it, C-bills, tonnage, and out of C-bills and tonnage kind of arose this idea of battle value. So what is a normal game of Battletech? Wow, how can we even really say that? Traditionally, and I say that because traditionally it's built around a lance, 4-max. You can bring a lance and maybe some support vehicles, one or two tanks, some infantry, and that kind of represents the core battle value, the core Battletech experience that you can grow from there. As soon as you go lower than that, there's less tactical options on the tabletop, and as soon as you go higher than that, the game is going to take longer to play, simply because more stuff on the table, means more in the action phases. Now, of course, how well-rounded you are with the rules and not having to look stuff up, that will speed a game up. But generally speaking, keeping in mind that the more battle value, the more and longer that the game is going to take. On average, I can do 6,000 battle value in maybe 4 or 5 hours. And that's playing at a very relaxed pace. That's kind of stepping back here and there and making tactical decisions and pushing that forward. A normal game completed in an evening, we've done as high as 8K battle value, but that's with a good mix in there. You know, some heavies, some assault mechs, 8K battle value, all lights and infantry. That's going to be massive on there. And of course, this needs to be adjusted. This is Inner Sphere. As soon as you go into the clan tech and the clan invasion, 6K battle value for clan mechs is nothing. That's like two, maybe three mechs. Well, okay, not two or three. Maybe three mechs on the table there, three assaults. Clan tech is very, very expensive. So if you're going to jump into the clans, you really want to adjust your battle value up another 2 or 3 or 4K. This way, you have kind of, although it's not the Lance, it's the Star configuration, you have enough toys to make tactical decisions on the tabletop on there. That's kind of the next step in figuring out your mission and then layering it over. Do you want attacker versus defender? So maybe some adjustments need to be made there. If I'm the attacker and you are defending a position, you have the advantage of selecting the deployment zone, maybe putting up some fortifications, maybe taking some key terrain. So maybe I should be thrown another 2 or 3K battle value. It's not, Battletech has a lot of complex moving parts, a lot of units, and the fact that it is true total warfare, unlike many other wargaming systems out there, say like Warhammer 40,000, Warhammer 40K has stratification in that you have infantry, you have tanks, you have, in theory, air support. You know, in theory, with Titans and other super heavies, you have mech support, but they all fall under the same phase and the same umbrella of rules on there. Battletech, the stratification means there's a lot more stuff, there's a lot more consideration on there. Battle value is never going to be an exact science, but it puts you about in that area.